story than me. How two hearts can come together and love can last forever. But now that I have found you, I believe that a miracle has come when God sends a perfect one. Now gone are all my questions about why, and I've never been so sure of anything in my life. Oh, I wonder what God was thinking when he created. All my dreams come true. When God made you, he must have been thinking about me.
Ooh. I promise that wherever you may go, wherever life may lead you, with all my heart I'll be there too. And from this moment on, I want you to know I'll let nothing come between us, and I will love the ones you love. Now gone are all my questions about why, and I've never been so sure of anything in my life.
What God was thinking when he created you. I wonder if he knew everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true. When God made you, he must have been harmonize in perfect tune. One can't rule without the other. They just have to be together. And that is why I know it's true. You're for me and I'm for you. 'Cause my world just can't be right,
can't be right
without you in my life. I wonder what God was thinking.
Sekan, at all the people who have come here today in a support. Just look around. These are the people that have cared for you, encouraged you, helped you to grow. They have prayed for you, joked with you, and likely about you. There are people here that sometimes simply put up with you because they love you. But all have come here today because you have in some small way or another impacted their life. And today, we want you to show their appreciation of that and support you again in this great decision of marriage. What a privilege and blessing to have this kind of relationship in our lives. This is what God intended to be, so to Him be all the glory. Let us pray. Father God, we are so grateful that you are the creator of heaven and earth, loves us and cares us and listen to our prayers. Lord, we ask you to bless Anthony and Honey today and every day in their marriage. Help them to keep you as the foundation of their lives and to love one another in good times and bad times. We ask all this in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us sit down. May I request everyone to sit down. Formula so salvation. He is the only way, He is the only truth, and the only life. Even this union, Christ is ang pinaka-sentro sa tanan ug siya ang author ani nga marriage. Ug again, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe in your heart that siya na banhaw, you will be saved. May I request everyone to follow this prayer. This prayer is a declaring that there's no other God sa atong kinabuhi. Before nato i-bless ni kaning marriage, ato sang dawaton si Christ as Lord and Savior. The Bible said, if you confess, so kinahanglan nato istorya na si Christ mao ang atong manluluwas. So follow this prayer kung wala pa kay relationship or wala pa ka kadawat sa atong buhi nga Ginoo. Dear Lord Jesus, I know that I am sinner. And I ask you for your forgiveness. And I believe you died for my sin and rose from the dead and turned from my sin. And I invite you to come in my heart and my life. I want to trust you, to follow you as my Lord and Savior. Amen. The Bible said in Genesis 2, verse 18 to 24, the Lord said, it is not good for a man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him. Now the Lord God have formed out of the ground all the wild animals and all the birds in the sky. He brought them to the man to see what he would name them. And whatever the man called each living creature, that was its name. So he gave a man all the name of the livestock, the birds in the sky, and the wild and the animals. But for Adam, no suitable helper was found. So the Lord God caused the man to fall into deep sleep. And while he was sleeping, he took one of man's rib. And then he closed up the place with flesh. Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib that he had taken out of the man. And he brought her to the man and he said, this is my bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called a woman, which is si Miss Sunny, ang gipili sa Ginoo for Anthony. For she was taken out from the man, that's why a man leave his father and mother and united to his wife, and they become one flesh. So after this ceremony, sila dili na lang dua, kundili two become one. You will be united by our Lord Jesus Christ. That's why, biblically, makita nato, you will see, if we read and understand the scripture, that it is the Lord who ordained the marriage. Agree ba ta? Ang papers, gikan lang nasa government, but it is the Lord nga nag-unite kani kay Anthony ug kay Honey. That's why very important na ma-understand nato what is marriage. And a little background, before ko buwan to sa ilang, sa ilahang love story, I met them before and I asked them what their love story, and I'm so amazed how God works in their lives. But before that, as a pastor, I have the joy of being part of many wedding ceremony. I get to sit down with the couples like I did with them. I talk with them. I ask them where and when they started with couples and hear about how they met, fell in love, and how their lives have been changed through their lives for one another. And it's easy to see that Anthony and Honey to do love each other. That's why the Bible, that's why kung pangutan na ta, what is love? Because in this world, there's a lot of definition of love, right? There's a love na unconditionally, na love na conditionally. Love is very common word. We use it to make different ways. We say, I love you. Sometimes we tell, I love you to our loved ones. To the person we care about most in the world. But we also say, sometimes we say, whatever we like, or you like chocolate, I love chocolate. Or whatever the things, you said, I love chocolate. Certainly, we don't love our significant or other the same way that we love chocolate or other things. Yet, we have no better words to express ourselves. So, what is love really? What is love really? According to scripture in 1 Corinthians 13, love is patient, love is kind, love is forgiving among many others. And other that, the scripture said, love never fails. Love never fails. And God is love. When the marriage, which is Christ, is the center, love never fails. It never fails because we love each other because we know that there is an author of love, which is the Lord Jesus Christ. We love because we know that God loves us first. Nakahigugma ta, nakashare ta, ug gugma, because nasayod kita nga si Lord mismo ang una nagigugma sa tuwa. Si Lord mismo nagigugma sa tuwa. That's why you love your soon-to-be wife after the ceremony, because the Lord loves you, Anthony. You love Anthony, Honey, because the Lord Jesus Christ loves you first. So we cannot give love without understanding what is love. That's why both of you love each other, because you know you are loved by God. And their story, they met online. They met online in year 2015. They were both single. At this time, in search for one true love. So they are searching for one true love. That's why naa sila karon diri nag-celebrate kung unsay gibuhat sa Ginoo sa ilang kinabuhi. Tony has a clinic and has a passionate with his profession as a doctor in oriental medicine. At the time, Honey was a student. So student pa si Honey ato during the time. I think she is graduating, kung di ko mamali. Who was about to graduate in her course as a BS Ed Bio. After years of constant communication and a long-distance talks, they finally met and found out that they are suitable for each other. So, suitable gin sila. Kay sama pa to sa gingon sa Bible nga ang walay lain nga suitable kay Adan. That's why niabot si Eva. Ipangitaan yun sa partner sa Ginoo, which is Eva. That's why sa ilahang constant communication, nakita nila nga they are suitable each other. And mana it's Tony waiting for a perfect one and as honey spread her wings to start career, the perfect time has found them and the love has bind them. Ang gugma sa Ginoo, the perfect time. That's why the Bible said that He made perfect in His time. God made perfect in His time. And this is the perfect moment that God has ordained. This is the perfect time. Beautiful time that God has prepared. And found them and love has bind them. They were today witnessing the love blossom and keep owning them for the last 7 years. So, 7 years na sila nga in relationship. That's why karon gipili nila nga mag-iusa duha, nga dili na sila ang mag-decide duha kung dili. I mean, dili na sila nag-inusara kung dili iusahon sila sa atong buhi na Ginoo. Amen? That's why love means being all of these things and notice that is about not about the feeling. So sometimes we base our love according to our emotion, our love, but love is not like that. The scripture said love is patient, love is kind, and love is forgiving among many things. Think about our emotion, the romance of falling in love and the desire to share every moment and to learn everything about this other person. We think that kind of love, we see movies that usually end with a wedding like this. Sometimes we look, we watch a movie and they end up a happy ending or a wedding forever. But love is far more than an emotion. So again, ang gugma, dili siya gabasi sa emotion. Far from than emotion. Emotion are fleeting. Our emotion sometimes weather lang, di ba? Usab-usab ba itong emotion? It changes. There's no sure in our emotion. They are here in one moment and gone to next. So sometimes nakakaroon, sometimes napod, wala. Anyone has been married longer than a day knows that the feeling of love comes and goes. Marriage, again, sama pa sa naka-experience, marriage is not easy because true love is more than a feeling. But it's a choice. So it's not an easy decision because it's our choice. Anthony and Honey, choice nila ni, nga nagminyo sila. Kaya nakita nila, sama sa akong bishare ganiha nga, their love story, they are suitable each other. Right, Anthony? Right, Honey?
Yes, sir.
Yes. If you want your marriage to be strong and to last, you must choose every day to love the other. If you choose to do this, your marriage will be one of the most fulfilling, rewarding, and fruitful parts of your entire life. So if you want your marriage to be strong and to be last forever, you must choose, both of you, not only Anthony, not only Honey, but both of you, choose every day to love each other. Do not look for your differences because the Bible said, love cover a multitude of sin. Whatever our failures, whatever our lackness, when we remember when and where you started, you will remember it started with the love. And love covers whatever our differences. You're both differences. That's why you need to understand. You need to remember when and where you started. The perfect example of love is found on Jesus. That's why I told you kaniha that for God so loved the world, He gave His only begotten Son. Her. choose day by day to love your wife by putting her desire ahead of your own, right? And honey, look at your husband. Choose to love Anthony by putting his desire ahead of your own. This feeling of your wedding day will fade in time. Kani mahuman dani, it's only pilala ka oras ang wedding. But ang marriage, kinahanglan na siya i-work out every day. That's why you need to choose to love every day. This celebration is only on this day. But your wedding, your marriage will be forever. You need to establish the love came from the Lord and choose to love every day. Choose to love your wife. Choose to love your husband every day. This feeling, again, this wedding, mahuman rani, mahingsunan, all of you na nag-witness, mahuman lang yun ni Satanan. Pero nag-witness mo nga sa ilahang journey, sa ilahang kaminyoon, makita nato umunsay buhaton ni Lord sa ilahang kinabuhi. I charge you, both of you, as you stand in the God's presence, to remember that love and loyalty alone will serve as the foundation of a happy and enduring home. If the solemnly vows which you are about to make are kept permanently by the grace of God, and if you steadfastly seek to do the will of your Heavenly Father, there's no other will of our Heavenly Father but to love each other. Because love, again, is the very important in this world. Your life will be full of peace and joy, and the home which you are establishing will abide through every change. So, again, seek to do the will of our Heavenly Father, which is according to the Scripture. Everything nagina sa pulong sa Ginoo. The Bible said that the man shall not live by the bread alone, but by the words that come from the mouth of God. So, very important in your relationship, you need the Lord day by day in your life. And charge to the parents. Parents. Asan itong parents who give the blessing? Ay, parents. Asang mama, papa? Nadre. To the parents, your main role with the relationship of this individual is to guide and encourage them to continue to love one another and not to empower them over their decision. So dili ta mag kanang magbuot-buot kung dili encourage or to guide them. To coach, i-coach nato sila ba? I-guide nato sila. So naman sila yung mga decision making, allow them to decide. Muna ang inyong role. Remember, parents, wala man ang parents ni Anthony, but I know you will told them about this. Remember, now that you have a new son. Parents ni Unsa, honey, you have a new son. Very handsome and very kind son. Right? And from your mother and parents, they have a new daughter, which is honey. Yeah. You are to assist them in times that they need you without expecting something return. So I believe, kani mga parents, wa amang gini katapusan ang pagatiman nila sa ilang anak, hantod sa pagminyo, hantod pag yun sa pag-apo. Tama, no? Magka-apo man sila, mga pila? 1,000? Sons and daughter? Ten daw kabuk, mga duwagin na siya ka basketball team. And I mean, the parents, I know, sugod pa sa sinugdanan ang inyong pagpangga sa ilaha, wagin na'y katapusan. Wagin mo nag-expect og return. Pero lagi, kina-train man ninyo og tarong ang inyong anak, di gid na kalimot sa inyo ha. Ayaw mo kabalaka. Even si honey nagminyo, di gid na makalimot sa inyo ha. Kay kabalo siya, because their parents is the first who dream to honey. Si ang ilahang ginikanan mo'y una nga nangandoy para kay honey. That's why honey always remember how good your parents. That's even sila nga wala naman sa inyo ha, or dili, whatever your whatever unsay inyo ang setup. This is my, I charge you to the sponsor. You are here not only to witness. You are not only here to witness the wedding, but also to take responsibility of assisting this couple. So, ang inyong responsibility is to assist them. Okay, right? Ninong ug ninang, assisting the couple for their moral, financial, kung naa, and even in spiritual needs. Pinaka-importante dere ang financial, musunod ra mong ginasya. Ang importante moral ug spiritual. Pinaka number one, spiritual. You need to guide them. Pinaagi sa giya sa Ginoo. Sabtan mga sponsor, mga witness, story in your children, in your grandchildren, and they will be amazed how you started. Even your parents, I know, one day they will look on your pictures. Oh, this is my mother. This is my daddy. It's very amazing, unique. How unique their love story. They started this one. So there's a story to be told in your future sons and daughter and coming grandchildren, right? So before we go to the vows, may I call the bridesmaid because there's na sila ay kanang presentation. We used to serenade by love song, but we will have the unique way of reflecting what love is today.
And all are wishing you well as you create a brand new chapter in the story that yours to tell. We talk about the memories you have yet to make together and the moments you've already shared to be carried with you forever. But take the time to live today as your marriage begins. Look around and soak it up, the moment we are in. For this is where the magic starts. When you both say your vows, you pledge to spend your lives as one because of the love you feel now. So, yes, here's to a future that is bright and warm and clear more than that. Here's to right now and what it means to be.
This momentous occasion we gather near to witness a love so precious and sincere. To the bride and groom, our cherished friends, may your love story have no end. May you always find comfort in each other's arm and be each other's rock, keeping you safe from harm. With love as your guide, a friendship so true, we wish you a lifetime of happiness and dreams that come true.
Such a big step, yet it's also a special day, whether we're ready or not. It's on its way, Coldfield, never that could never be. My love for you is deeper than the deep blue sea. I'm ready to say I do. There's no doubt about that. I'm ready to say I do. My darling, I always love you.
Miles apart. In love's embrace, though miles apart, two hearts entwined, a work of art. A journey taken, hand in hand, a love that thrives in every land. Through screens and calls, the bond does grow. A love that's real, a steady glow. Distance can dim the flame that's true, for love transcends and bridges, though. In separate worlds, yet deeply connected, the love they share remains unaffected. Though time zones crossed and oceans wide, in each other's hearts they always reside. They've counted days, they've counted nights, through lonely moments and dazzling heights. Their love's a story unique and rare, a testament to the strength they bear. So here's to the couple who conquered space, whose love shines bright, a guiding grace. May your path ahead be filled with light. As you continue this journey, side by side, with every step your love shall grow, a beacon of hope forever glow. Distance is just a test you've surpassed, for in each other's love you're steadfast. So raise a toast to love so strong, to a future where you both belong. Though miles may separate your view, your love unites eternal and true.
Wow, let's clap our hands.
Pixels and apps they found love's tender flame on Omegle's ground. Digital highs and hellos, a faithful start. Two hearts connected, the worlds apart. Years unfolded, 8 years, their bond took flight. Virtual quarrels, virtual hugs, and petty fights. Strengthened by the pandemic and cultural difference, their love is carved out, heart found its own place. Tita Honey, a friend of mine, a heart so pure, so innocent. Brilliance, love to endure. Tony, a name, a distant mystery, yet love's force shape their shared history. Oceans crossed, a journey of faith. Tony's flight to meet, love's conquest to save. First meeting, a spark, a timeless embrace. Moments of togetherness, such a love's grace. They endured the distance with hearts so true. Love conquered all and their fate pursue. Now they stand at love's altar so ground. Two souls entwined hand in hand. As they step into marriage's embrace, I raise my glass, a toast to their grace. To Tita Honey and Tony, a future so bright. Cheers to forever, you'll be all right. In each other, you found the love to stand. A lifelong journey together under the same sky.
Here's a poem entitled New Beginnings by Barbara Croker. May this day be a day of new beginnings. The sun, like a fragrant apple, the summer air, soft on your hands as the kiss of a child. May berries melt like honey on your tongue. May your heart rise in wonder at the clouds drifting across the sky. May the trails under your boots be covered in pine quills. Let the leaves rain down like memories in the autumn of your heart. May the snow beneath your skis run as fast as water silk. May the cold air kiss your cheeks, turn them red as summer's roses. May the rivers always flow with their unexpected beauty. The first freshets of snow melt, the rush of early spring. May you always walk in gladness through whatever path or highway. May you always walk within the golden circle of your love.
So, okay, to sum it all. Once there was a girl named Honey, met a guy named Anthony. Fascinated by their very great story, here we are, witnessing a fantasy. Their love is immeasurable. They traveled every country in the world for sure. But once the heart settled, all they think is how to be together. I wish you all the best in life, Bibi. I know you'll be a great wife. May you make a dozen of cute little babies. Tony, good luck. And please don't worry. I love you both with all my heart. I pray to God that you'll never depart. So yeah, welcome to the married life. You're gonna love it. Good luck. I love you.
In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I.
I. Anthony Stephen Olson.
Take you. Her full name.
Honey Jane Declan Serino.
To be my wife.
To hug and to hold.
From this day forward. For better and for worse. For richer and for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. All of the days of my life. Until we part by death. This is my solemn vow.
Give the mic to Honey. And please repeat after me and the same.
In the name of God.
I, Honey Jane D. Serino.
Take you,
Anthony Olsen.
To be my husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better and for worse. For richer and for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish.
In all the days of my life.
Until we parted by death. This is my solemn vow. Now the sign of their promise to one another, Anthony and Honey are going to exchange vow. His personal vow, or there's a written vow. Kung naman mga written or vow.
I promise from this day forward to work every single moment with you to create a beautiful family with high morals, intelligence, care, and love for all their friends and family, and to excel in the life we have with luck, with joy, and with care. I will be here for you, and we will travel the world, and we will find our home. Amen.
Anthony, in you I found love, kindness, patience, and compassion. You are my strength and my weakness. We may be separated by distance, but our hearts are always connected. From this day forward, I promise to cherish you, love you, care for you, and respect you. I love you very much.
Let's clap our hands. But before that, the bride has a surprise. She will sing.
Earth was just a field of cold, alone. is all about you. Been rehearsing for this moment all my life, so don't act surprised if the feeling starts to carry me away. On this day, I promise forever. On this day, I surrender.
Can we clap our hands?
Wow, what a one. Sweet. Honey. Honey first. And repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I wed you and pledge to you.
Wed you and pledge to you.
My loyalty and love.
My loyalty and love.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
Of the Son.
Of the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
I wed you.
I wed you.
Amen.
Amen.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed. And I pledge to you.
And I pledge to you.
My loyalty and love.
My loyalty and love.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
The Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
I wed you.
I wed you.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, as the sign of their commitment to one another, Anthony and Honey are going to participate in the lighting. Hold your candle in the space. The Bible said, John, God is the light, and in Him there is no darkness at all. Always remember that God is the light in your marriage. In Him there is no darkness. That's why the Bible said, two become one. Right? You need to communicate each other. You need to talk to each other, because from now on, you are not separated. But by God's grace, you will be one. Two will become one. As a symbol, as you know, I stand there, you acknowledge you are united with the Lord Jesus Christ. Let us witness this couple to light the unity candle. The Bible is a symbol of submission to God, giving Him the authority over your marital life, being head. With this Bible, I desire to follow God's way. And encourage you
as my spouse,
to do the same. I also commit to God that I will love Him more than I love you. As an evidence of my love for you. Today, I recognize
that without him,
there is no us. May God bless our family. that God is the author of everything. Father God, Lord, we thank you for this wonderful moment. Lord, I bless this couple by your name, the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Lord, bind them by your love. And Lord, continue to spread, Lord, and manifest your love to them because you are the author of everything, O God. Lord, may this couple, Lord, will acknowledge always that marriage is you. You are the author of everything, O God. Father God, salamat Ginoo sa imong pagkamaayo sa ilang kinabuhi. I-bless nimo ang matag-usa nila ka kinabuhi. Salamat, Father, that ang ilahang pangandoy, imuha pong pangandoy para kanila, Lord God. That, Lord, salamat Ginoo na ikaw mag-abine kanunay kanila, Ginoo. That this love, Lord, will continue to flow in their lives. That even the works of the enemy, Lord God, will not prosper to them because they are covered by your blood in Jesus' name. Today, Lord, I declare blessing upon blessing to their lives in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for honoring this marriage because you are the author of this marriage. Lord, bless them, and bind them by your love in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for everything what you have done. Thank you, Lord, that from generation to generation of Anthony, of Honey, will acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord in their lives, O God. May the Lord bless you, and may the Lord keep you, and make His face shine upon you, and be gracious unto you. The Lord turn His face towards you, and give you peace. Palakpakan ato itong buhi na Ginoo. May request this couple to sign this marriage. Now that Anthony and Honey has given themselves to each other by the promises that they have exchanged and they signed their marriage license as officiating minister and the bishop of New Covenant Christian Community Outreach Incorporated and by the authority invested in me by the Republic of the Philippines and by the Lord Jesus Christ as He is the head of the church, I pronounce them to be husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may now kiss the bride. Can you face the congregation and hold the hands in your wife? Ladies and gentlemen,
and welcome to the wedding day of Mr. and Mrs. Olsen. A round of applause, please. There you have it. Ladies and gentlemen, I know it's a weekend, but look at you. You are celebrating with us. Kaya naman po, I say daghan kayong salamat. But of course, ladies and gentlemen, just before we begin this wonderful occasion, allow me to introduce myself. Maari ba akong magpakilala? Pwede ba? Atong naririnig, pwede ba? Ayon, hindi po ako artista na malakutis porselana, ngunit ako po ang prinsipe na para sa inyo ay itinadhana. Ako po inyong Mindanao's Young Host of the Year, Mr. Prince Guy, at your service. Palakpakan naman dyan. There you have it. Ma'am and sir, thank you very much for gracing us with your time, presence, and effort. That one is truly talagang na-appreciate ng ating bride and groom. Now this time, we would like to begin this wonderful occasion by acknowledging the parents of our bride and groom. Mommy, Daddy, pag natawag tayo, tayo po tayo kaway-kaway sa inyong mga fans. To begin, we would like to acknowledge here the parents of the bride, starting with Mommy Berlin Sorino. Palakpakan naman dyan! Nako, akala ko po, maid of honor, mommy, and very beautiful indeed. And of course, thank you very much, mommy. We would like to acknowledge as well, daddy, Virgilio Sorino. Palakpaka naman dyan, kaway-kaway naman dyan. Ayan po, welcome, sir, in this wonderful occasion. Ang Coco Martin ng Davao City, there you go. And of course, we would like to acknowledge as well the parents of our groom as... We are actually celebrating together with Mama Louise, Valerie Olsen, and Daddy Stephen Anthony Olsen. Let's give them a round of applause. Malakpakan naman dyan. There you go. Now this time, we would like to acknowledge our Ninong and Ninang. Ninong and Ninang, mahaba-haba po ang listahan. Allow me to acknowledge you as one. With that, so may I have all the Ninong and Ninang po. Tayo po tayo, Ninong and Ninang. Let's all stand up, Ninong and Ninang, so that everyone may recognize you. Ninong, Ninang, tindog tayo. Tayo po tayo. There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, palakpakan po natin ating mga Ninong and Ninang. Welcome, Ninong and Ninang. Maraming salamat po this time. Ladies and gentlemen, dakang salamat, Ninong and Ninang. You may now enjoy your seats. This time, ladies and gentlemen, are you excited to welcome our
Bruce Austin? A round of applause, please.
At the center, as we will have your first dance, honor dance together with the parents. Palakpakan po natin, ladies and gentlemen, our groom together with his mother. Palakpakan naman dyan. Gentlemen, let's give a hand to our groom together with his mother. A round of applause, please. Thank you very much, Anthony. Thank you very much, Mommy Merlin. You may now have your seat. This time, we will give a chance to the father of the bride to have a dance together with his daughter. Kaya naman po, to Daddy Virgilio, dyan po tayo. At isasayaw po natin ang ating anak. That one po is a symbolism of pasasalamat. We say daghan kayong salamat for raising Honey Jane as a great daughter. Palakpakan po natin, ladies and gentlemen, our bride together with her father. Palakpakan naman dyan. And of course, this time, may request Sir Anthony. And dito po tayo, sir. Palakpakan po natin the daddy of the bride. Daghang salamat. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, watch so close as we are about to witness their very first dance as Mr. and Mrs. Olsen. A round of applause, please. Pa kayo mga kamay dyan. But of course, just before we end this dance, I've heard someone kanina na may nagsabing kiss. Kaya naman, ladies and gentlemen, what's the pleasure of the mob? Ano po ang sigaw ng taong bayan? I'm hearing a request over here, a kiss. Okay, that's right after the cue. Go pa po, ma'am. Oo, talagang very excited po ating bride and groom. Let's do it again in 3, 2, 1, go! Let's give a hand to our bride and groom. Palakpakan po natin our bride and groom. This time, to our bride and groom, please be here po beside our wedding cake. And of course, kindly get to your knife over there as we will have the slicing of the wedding cake. There you go. All right. Okay, this time, you'll be slicing it together, ma'am and sir. There you go. We'll be using only one knife. There you go. We'll be using only one knife for this slicing of the wedding cake, ma'am and sir. Which one? There you go. But of course, before that, well, let's take a picture together with your wedding cake. With your greatest smiles in 3, 2, 1. This time, ladies and gentlemen, we are now witnessing their hands moving as one. Their hands moving as one symbolizes oneness and unity of their relationship through this sacrament of matrimony. There you go. And of course, do not forget to transfer our piece of cake to the saucer available on the side of our cake. There you go. And be here at the center as we will be eating the piece of our wedding cake, ma'am, sir. Dito po tayo sa gitna. Alright, and of course, sir to Anthony. There you have the bigger the love that you have for each other. Let us see how big is your love, Tony and Honey, for each other. May we have first our bride? Wow, what a big love for Tony and for Sir Tony. Please express your love to Honey. There you have it. We have here one whole piece of cake for Mom Honey. There you go. Talagang malaki-laki pang pagmamahal ni Sir Tony. There you go. Palakpakan po natin, ladies and gentlemen, the eating of the wedding cake. Thank you very much, ma'am and sir. Daghang salamat. Now, just before dinner time, we'll be here.
Honey, Annie Jane, my message is, first of all, I would like to say congratulations after all the circumstances, the kaneng mga pagsubok, nga before the marriage, before this kaning special day, na overcome ra ninyo ang inyohang mga katong mga naagi nga mga dili mga pagkaunawaan, charot. Tapos my wish is a full of happiness together with each other. And then, I hope that may the Lord God bless your marriage with full of love, respect, and understanding for kanang throughout the years within the marriage. And then, full of love lang ni Gud. And sa inyuhang tawag ani, nga sa mga battles throughout the marriage nga inyo rang ma-overcome nga with respect with each other lang gihapon and full of love, understanding, respect. Nagbalik-balik na. Okay. Ready. Basta I'm one of the happiest nga karon ni abot na ang day nga nagsay na gid mo og I do. And congratulations, Tony and Honey.
There you please stay there, ma'am, as we will be joined by our best man. Ladies and gentlemen, this time we will hear words so vicious coming from our best man. Help me welcome none other than Mr. James Serino. A round of applause, please.
Thank you very much. To Honey and Anthony, congratulations. So we're gathered here today to witness this event. On behalf of our family, we're very thankful to everyone, bro. Thank you very much. Even though you're the only one from your side, takes much courage to do that. To travel from a very far place, then going here just to marry my beautiful sister. To you guys, to my sister, Bibi, I hope that you should try to, just a little bit, try to control your temper. Your husband is very intelligent man, and yeah, you'll get along. You'll get along. And that would be all, because my English speaking skills are not that good. So thank you very much.
Maybe we could have a lot more of your messages through Messenger, sir. Sir, please stay there. And to our matron of honor, ma'am, please do the honor of giving our wine glasses to our newlyweds. And maybe invite our newlyweds to be here at the center so that everyone may witness the wine toasting that we have prepared for this wonderful night. There you go. Yes, po. Ibigay po natin sa ating bride and groom. And sir, please get your wine glass po. Ayon. So our bride and groom, do not forget to entwine your arms to each other. And of course, cross your arms to lock up the love that we have prepared for each other. But before that one, our best man would do the initial saying of cheers, sir. Ang gagawin niyo po, you will be saying cheers. But before that one, may I invite everyone to please stand up. Ma'am and sir, please grab your wine glasses on your respective table and stand up. And to our best man, please do the honor in saying, sir, cheers. Sige po.
Okay, here's a 1, 2, 3. Cheers!
Cheers for our newlyweds. There you go. There you have it. And cheers. There you go. Ayan. And a Filipino tradition. Let us ring our glasses using our fork. Spoon, Paul, let us make a sound and everybody say cheers. Ladies and gentlemen, what's the pleasure of the mob? Ano po ang sigaw ng taong bayan? I'm not hearing anything. Ano po ang sigaw ng taong bayan? Kiss. May we have a kiss over here? All right, let's do the kiss. Let's do it in 3, 2, 1. Ladies and gentlemen, palakpan po natin our newlyweds. There you go. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing as Ninang Sheila De Ligero. A round of applause, please. Nako, talagang sila po ang namili. Ma'am, trabaho lang po ang akin. Oo. Palakpan po natin, ladies and gentlemen, we have here Ninang Sheila De Ligero. Palakpa ka naman dyan. There you go.
Pa ako kahinga, busog pa kayo. Okay. Tony and Honey, hats off for both of you. At first, I was very reluctant when Honey told me that I would give a word about marriage, since I'm not worthy to say something because I'm from a broken marriage. Most of you here knew about my life. But then, maybe this is my way to say that in order for you to sustain the marriage is to respect each other's decision. Love each other unconditionally. And Tony, all I can say is to make your life happy, make your wife happy every single day. That's all, and thank you.
There you have it. Coming from Ninang Sheila Deligero. Palakpakan naman dyan. Thank you very much, Ninang. And I hope that you will always remember the message coming from Ninang Sheila. This time, another Ninang has been chosen by our newlyweds. And to give more words of wisdom or mga payo po is the Ninang. Ninang Vilma Deligero. A round of applause, please. Ayan po, Ninang Sheila, you are about to give. Let's have your another name, Ninang Normelita Makoro. Palakpakan naman dyan. Ako, Ninang, wala kang kawala, Ninang. Magsi-CR sana si Ninang. But of course, konting wisdom po, words of wisdom para sa ating couple. Ninang?
Maayong hapon sa tanan. Yung nata mag-English, ani, kay... Okay. Bibi and Tony, karon pag yung kukaklaro sa iyang itsura ba, wapo gyud si Tony, no? Okay. Wala na ako masulti gyud, no, nga... kami nyo on, dili gyud siya perfect. So, naagyud ng away, labi na kay Bibi na... Medyo bata pa kay Tony. So, Tony, kinahanglan yun ang imuhang understanding kay Bibi. No? So, i-translate that, Bibi. Kay Lison naman, bininglis na rin na di na ito magkasinabot. Okay, so, ako alang ka nang napagyod mo karon mag-adjust pagyod mo, labi na kay Bibi na nadirin, ato sa layo. So, ang ako alang, mo lang to siya. Tell death, do your part. Maulang.
Thank you very much, Ninang. Ano? And of course, you need to have understanding and communication, good communication to each other. Palakpakan po natin our Ninong and Ninang. Palakpakan naman dyan. You know what? To our groom and to our bride, your Ninong and Ninang, your godparents, is always there for you no matter what. They are there for you physically, emotionally, mentally, and even spiritually. With that said, they deserve a round of applause. Palakpak naman for our Ninong and Ninang. Dagang salamat, Ninong and Ninang. This time, after hearing the words of wisdom po mula sa ating mga Ninong and Ninang, we're gonna hear it coming from the parent representative of our bride and groom. Talagang hindi pwedeng silang lahat, pero they have chosen one to represent them all. And to do that one, help me welcome none other than Mama Marlene D. Sereno. Palakpakan naman dyan. Ako, Mami, wala tayong kawala. Oo, mga words of wisdom. Tambag po. Talagang nagadala na po ng script si Mami ngayong araw na ito. Oo. Wow. She came prepared for this speech. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a hand to Mami Marlene Sereno. Palakpakan naman dyan.
And for you, honey, please understand my grammar. And here, please understand me. Happy wedding and congratulations to you, my daughter, and to you, Tony, my new son. Welcome to our family. Yay! By the way, I'm very thankful for all of you here. We really appreciate your presence to relatives, sponsors, and friends. Thank you very much for coming. For me, I'm really happy for you, Tony and Honey, that at last they are already tied up. For Tony, thank you for your sacrifices. Even you are very far from here. But because of your love for Honey, that's why you are here. And we really appreciate your effort and love for my daughter. I know that you're a good man. And I hope that your love for my daughter will be forever. And I trust my daughter to you as her husband. Please love her as you love yourself. And for Honey, my baby, you are now a woman, a wife, and you're no longer my baby. It's time to change all for your goodness as a wife. And as I told you, be slow always. I know that you're a very strong woman. You're a good daughter, and please, love Tony also, as you love yourself. And you both has a strong personality. A strong personality is good. Why? Because it's a good asset when in terms of your job, on your daily activities. That's why that is very good asset. But please, 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 be gentle to your husband. Especially your voice. Like, by not raising your voice, by not raising your voice to him, to Tony, or to be what you need now is caress and tenderness. The finest secret to a successful marriage is to speak softly to one another. Additionally, each scenario requires comprehension and communication. With all decisions made, should take the place of debate. Did you get me? Let me give you some case. Case to a happy, happy marriage, happy relationship. Do you know that there are magic words for a happy marriage? First, the word sorry. Always say sorry in times of misunderstanding. Second, say I love you. Always say I love you. When is the perfect time to say I love you? For me, it's when you wake up early in the morning. Say, good morning. Good morning, my love. Yeah. Say I love you to your partner so that your day is full of love. Yeah. And when you are... is when you are going to sleep. Say, I love you, so you can sleep tight, even you are in quarrel. Third, say thank you always. Say thank you to your partner. Saying thank you is a compliment to your partner. Yeah. Don't let your partner be sad. Always think for his happiness. There are more. Time out. Say time out. If okay. And now another key for a happy marriage. As what we observed earlier, Ali carried the Bible. Yeah. And why the Bible is included in your marriage? Because this is the living word of God. Yeah? In 2 Timothy 3:16, all scriptures, when we read the verse, it says, all scriptures, or the Bible, that is scriptures, all scriptures is inspired of God and beneficial for teaching, for reproving, or setting things straight for discipline and righteousness. So, God wants that he will be the third party on your marriage so that it will be strong. Not the third party, other woman or other man, but you make the God as third party so that your marriage will be strong. I have an illustration here. Illustration. When you see a knot, a rope is made of twisting together with three strands to be strong. Did you observe? I have here a rope. Yeah. Rope or not? This is a rope. Yeah. This rope is made of three strands. This is Honey, this is Tony, and who is this? Yeah. When you put together, this will be strong. Yeah. When this only two, are they strong? No. So, you must, the very good is you must put God in your relationship so that it will be successful. Did you get me?
Yeah.
And okay, thank you, babe. Okay, thank you. You can talk to God, another king. You can talk to God regularly by means of prayer. Praying together is another key that your marriage will be successful. You must have an spiritual activities in your life. And that is very important. Try to do that and do not ignore that you know about the true God. And for Tony, where is Tony? And for Tony, you know already that Hannah's God is Jehovah. Yeah? And supporting her someday will lead to your happy life. Yeah. Jehovah is the creator of all things. That's Hannah's God. That's the true God in the Bible. May Jehovah God bless your marriage. And thank you.
Wala ba yung mga kamay dyan? And roll!
We going on vacation, so where you wanna go?
Me? Obsessed with you? Yes.
Wala ba kamay dyan? Once again, let's do it. Ayan po pala po at una the ladies and gentlemen, our matron of honor together with the bridesmaid. Ayan, ladies, may I request you to be here at the center. Dito muna tayo sa gitna, alright? Be here at the center. Dito po tayo. And of course, our matron of honor. Ayan, meron na po ata. Alright. There you go. All right, dito po tayo at the center and may I borrow this one because we will now have the throwing of the bouquet. And you know, the one who will get this one will be the next in line. There you go. Kaya naman, ladies, be here at the center. Dito po tayo. Talaga, excited si ating magpakasal. Oo, all right. Sige po. Let's do the throwing of the bouquet. You count with me. Let's do a countdown after the cue go. You're gonna throw that one after the go. All right. And of course, we need to about face, siempre. All right. And are you now ready, Miss Bride? Mrs. Bride this time. Are you now ready, girls? Ready. Let's do it. Count with me in 3, 2, 1, go. Nako, all right, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give a hand to our future bride. Palakpakan naman dyan. Ma'am Honey, together with Anthony, Sir Anthony, be here as we'll be taking a picture together with our future bride. And we hope, ma'am, imbitado din po ang lahat na nandito as you will have your wedding very soon. There you have it, your greatest of smiles in 3, 2, 1. Palakpakan po natin, ladies and gentlemen, our future bride in line. Thank you very much, ma'am, for such a good sport. This time, just before we end the celebration, we will now hear the most awaited speech in the hall. Other than the speech of our newlyweds, we have here...
I really, really, really want to thank each and every one of you for being here today. It really means a lot to us. I know it means a huge amount to Honey and her family. I'm looking forward to seeing you all again soon and doing many things in the future that are fun, but I appreciate your patience today. I know that sometimes some people talk a long time during ceremonies. We said keep it short. He was praising God a lot, and it goes on. So we have to be patient, but we got some food. I hope you enjoyed your cake. Thank you for coming here. We look forward to being with you all again shortly. And I'm sure Honey will send photos to every one of you. Okay, thank you.
Thank you everyone for celebrating with us today. Thank you sa akong mga ninong ug ninang. It's like the distance of this place from our place is too far, but you really find time to come here or to celebrate with us. Thank you so much. Thank you to my friends, to my matrons of honor, Dara, Ate Lotlot, and Ate G. Thank you so much. Sa ako ang mga bridesmaids, Glidel, Irene, and Laika, thank you. Sa among makeup artists, thank you so much for making us beautiful today. And of course, sa among photographers who were like very patient, thank you so much. And of course, sa ako ang parents, thank you. Kaayo, for your patience and for loving us both. And of course, sa ako ang kuya. And kay Ate Julie. Okay, thank you so much. And sa ako ang relatives, sila Mama Bibe, Ate Sheila, Tatay Proni. Thank you, kaayo. And that's all. Thank you, everyone.
I'm now remembering that I want to say a few more things. First of all, to my brother James, he has made me feel safe and welcome here every time I've been around him. He's a wonderful man, and I look forward to being with him and his family in the future. So here's to James. Give him a round of applause. He is a great human.
Let's give him a round of applause. There you go.
And he helped create, I have a younger sister too. We affect our younger siblings. He helped create Honey, and their relationship is more solid probably than any other relationship they'll have in their lives. Sometimes it's hard, but it's always there, right? Okay, and then thank you for your speech. The poems were amazing, but your speech touches me because I know how much effort you put into it too, and I want to thank you for all of that. And I want to thank the kids and Julie. Every time I'm here, they're the thing that makes me smile. One of the reasons I want to be with Honey so much is I know that we could, and hopefully will, have a wonderful family. And I hope our children are as good as your two children. They're amazing people. So that's all. And thank you, sir. Yeah, thank you.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. We know that you have a lot of friends, relatives, and even loved ones, but you have personally chosen us to become a part of this celebration. On behalf of all your guests, we say in our language, daghan kaayong salamat, or thank you very much for inviting us all. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give them a round of applause. There you have it. And of course, to all our suppliers and our sponsors, thank you very much. And to end this celebration, may I invite everyone to be here on stage, or shall we say, on the center aisle, as we will take one great family photo together with you once again. May I request everyone to be here, Ma'am Honey, Sir Anthony, be here at the center, together with all your guests. Ma'am Sir, tara na po, dito po tayo sa gitna before we say, mabuhay ang bagong kasal. Diyan po tayo, Ma'am Sir, be there at the center, lahat po. Everyone in this house. There you go. Thank you very much for the music, Kuya. All right. One more. Wacky naman this time. 3, 2, 1. Wacky. All right. Please stay there, ma'am and sir, because together we will say in our language, the long live newlyweds is translated to mabuhay ang bagong kasal. And ma'am and sir, pwede mo naman natin ang Filipino culture as we say, anong sasabihin? Oh, grabe naman. Practice pa nga lang yun. All right, let's do it again after my cue go. Together in 3, 2, 1, go! Mabuhay ang bagong kasal! This has been Mr. and Mrs. Hobson. Daghang salamat and enjoy the rest of the day. This has been your host, your...